Developers are geeks, and geeks love discovering new tools. When it comes to productivity, optimization, or just making your workflow smoother, we're always in the look for something new. So in this video, we're diving into some awesome website that every developer should know about. Let's get started. So first up is Database Builder. This website is amazing. You enter a prompt describing the project you want to build a database for, and it generates everything related to the database, including all the relations. Here's how to use it. First, write a prompt for the project you want to use this website for. I'm going with this default one, a clone of Slack. Then hit enter. Now you'll see the executed SQL commands, which you can use right away. If you'd like to remove or add any part of the database, just chat with the AI. It will adjust everything to fit your needs. You can even connect your own LLM. So if you're a developer, you probably know about what that means. If you want to download the schema, just click the three dots here and select download. There's also an option to deploy it directly to Supabase, and AWS support is coming soon. By clicking on this share button, you can live share your browser using a URI or PSQL. So you can use it in your Postgres client or with database related extensions in VS Code, which I introduced in my last VS Code extensions video, or really any tool you're comfortable with. Next up is quickref.me, a super useful tool for cheat sheets. Whether you're a developer or a power user of different apps, there are cheat sheets for almost anything. Programming toolkits, Linux, Python, databases, keyboard shortcuts, and more. For example, let's say I want to learn Bash. I just click on this button, and it provides a step-by-step hash-style documentation to help you get started. It begins by teaching you how to define a variable and print it. Scrolling down a bit, and in the middle section, it shows you how to create loops in Bash. And the last section covers how to pass arguments into arrays. Super useful and honestly really fun to explore. As I mentioned, it's not just for developers. Quickref.me also works great for power users. If you head into the keyboard shortcuts section, you'll find shortcuts for tons of applications you might want to master. For example, I'll go with Spotify. Just a quick reminder, in my last video I showed how to make Spotify look and feel way better using a tool that adds extension, themes, premium-like features, and so much more. So feel free to check that out. It's a great way to streamline your workflow with Spotify. As you can see, here are all of the shortcuts for the Spotify client. So if you use it a lot, work for long hours, or just want to move faster without relying on the mouse, learning these shortcuts will definitely boost your productivity. Next is Git Diagram, a tool that I really love. If you're a high-level developer, you already know that starting a big project isn't as easy as it looks. This tool is created because most code bases are just too massive to dig through manually. It helps you break things down visually. Just paste the GitHub URL here. The tool will analyze how the project works. Front-end, back-end, quality, pretty much everything. You can export the diagram, enable zoom, and even customize it using AI to suit your preference. If the repo you want to analyze is private, no worries. Just click on the private repo option and enter your GitHub token. There's also a section called API key where you can add your OpenAI key to enable chatting with the AI right inside your browser, personalized for your project. And if you like any of these projects, please give them a star on GitHub. We all know how important it is in the open source community. Oh, and there's a quick tip. If you're on the GitHub page and want to access this website directly, just click on your address bar and click here, then write gitdiagram.com/. And now when you hit enter, this will directly forward you to the Git Diagram website. Easy and fast. Next up is GetIngest. But before diving into what it does, I want to quickly highlight its design and frontend. It looks really similar to Git Diagram because both use a new design system called Pandas CSS. Definitely worth checking out. If you like how it looks, you might consider using it for your next project. To get started, just enter the GitHub project URL. Once it loads, you can exclude specific files you don't want to be included in the text file. You have also the option to choose whether the file sizes should be shown alongside the code or not. Below that, there's a compact summary section showing the repository names, files analyzed, and estimated token count. Next to that is the directory structure. which you can explore in detail. And the final section shows file contents, giving you everything you need to use this code with AI to analyze, build on, or even refactor. There's also a browser extension for this tool, so install it, and then every time you visit a GitHub project, a new button will appear. Click it, and it will open the project directly in the GetIngest website. And if you want to skip the extension and go straight to it yourself, just copy the GitHub project URL, then go to getingest.com/, and after that will be the project URL. So now when you hit enter, this will forward you to the GetIngest website. That's it. It will load everything for you automatically. Next up is JSON Viewer Pro. Once you install the JSON Viewer Pro extension, it takes those messy raw JSON API responses and turns them into something readable and organized. No more struggling with the giant walls of text. Just open your response and the extension formats it automatically. You can collapse or expand any section of the JSON response to focus only on what you need. At the top, there is a handy search bar where you can type a dot and the name of the variable to instantly find what you're looking for. By default, it displays your JSON in a tree format, but my favorite view is this chart format. Just click on it and it will visualize your JSON structure as a chart, perfect for quickly understanding complex responses. And if you want to load your own JSON manually, just click on the JSON editor, paste or upload your file, then click parse as JSON to instantly format and view it cleanly. There's also a theme setting if you prefer a different look, and you can configure it to avoid opening specific web pages automatically with the viewer. Overall, it's a super useful tool that makes working with JSON much easier and way more enjoyable. Next is CSS-Tricks. And hey, backend devs, don't skip this part just yet. Before we dive into this website, you might just notice it's powered by DigitalOcean. But let's be honest, their VPS pricing isn't exactly budget friendly. I actually made a video about the best VPS providers that offer cheap, high quality servers with unlimited traffic. So if you're in the market for one, check out the link in the top right corner or down in the description. Alright, let's get back to CSS-Tricks. This site is like a gold mine for front-end developers, packed with awesome articles. It's perfect for learning something new in your free time. Let's take a look at this popular article called Revisiting CSS Multi-Column Layouts. A quick summary. Despite its early limitation and underuse, CSS Multi-Column Layout is now a powerful, flexible tool, especially when combined with modern features like container queries and clamp to enhance readability without relying on media queries. It says that designers should revisit as it solves many past issues and enables elegant, responsive layout with minimal effort. Thanks to Andrew Clark for this clean and super useful write-up. Now shifting gears. Git and GitHub are absolutely essential for developers, but let's be real, they're hard. And trying to figure out how to fix your own mistakes in Git can feel impossible. The documentation is so hard to figure out how it works, and you can search how to fix your issue unless you already know what it's called. That's where this next website comes in clutch. It's full of commands and real-life examples of what to do after you mess something up. For example, let's say you've just committed some code and immediately realize you need to make a small change. With one simple command, you can edit the file and have that fixed file included in your last commit. Super easy and incredibly useful. And the last website is Diff Checker. Sometimes, especially for smaller projects like university assignments, you might not want to set up a full Git version control, but you still want to see what's changed. Maybe you made a few tweaks or your teammate did something and you want to compare. Just head to Diff Checker, paste in your original and modified code. It will highlight every change line by line. Super handy when you're working outside of Git or just want a quick comparison. And that wraps it up. Hope you found some tools today that will seriously level up your dev game. If you enjoyed this one, I'm sure you'll love the first part of our useful dev websites series. So go check it out. Drop a like, subscribe for more, and let me know in the comments which tool blew your mind, or if there's one I should feature next. Catch you in the next one.